Pat Pedwarden relishes his daily walk with his wife, Lori, because not too long ago, he could barely even make it across a parking lot.
I was hoping my face was all red, and anybody walking by me would say, "So do you need any help?" I said, no, I'm okay, I'm okay.
He was not okay, and one day he realized he needed help.
I came home and went to the cardiologist, just 5 minutes from here. He checked me and he said, we're going to admit you in the hospital. I said, okay. I know I'm not doing well because I'm huffing and puffing now. So they admitted me in the hospital, kept me there for 5-6 days. Again, all the tests they ran on me with very little answers.
There was swelling in his abdomen, legs, and chest, but doctors couldn't pinpoint the exact cause. They suspected it was heart failure, so they called Dr. Ryan Dwake. He was working on a new test to detect heart failure using an existing device that measures a patient's breath to diagnose illnesses like kidney and liver disease.
If we look at something we call the breath print, which is just a summation of all these different compounds in the breath, it's quite different, like you have a fingerprint, you know. So the breath print is something similar, where there are changes, minute changes in your breath that reflect what underlying disease you have, and that's what we found in these patients.
Researchers are looking for volatile organic compounds in one's breath. Elevated levels of certain compounds can be caused by disease and can alert doctors to an underlying condition.
We have specific compounds, like acetone and pentane. We found that they're elevated in patients with heart failure.
Pat Pedwarden's breath test confirmed the doctor's suspicions. His heart was failing. The test is rather simple to take. Here's how it works. Patients blow into an analyzer that is connected to a computer, which breaks down and logs all of the components in that breath. If a patient is bedridden, they can blow into an airtight bag, which is then connected to the computer for analysis.
The advantage of this test, of course, is non-invasive and non-intrusive. If you think about it, you know, even a urine test, you know, you have to go into a bathroom to give a urine sample. The breath test, you can do it anywhere, any place, and it's very non-invasive. You just blow into a device. So that's the advantage of the technique itself.
While results of the breath test are promising, a larger study is underway. The hope is that doctors will not only be able to confirm a heart patient's diagnosis, but to also use the device as a screening tool.
Heart failure patients, sometimes they're doing well, they're at home, they're taking their medications, they're active, you know, with limitations. But then something happens, they get decompensated, they need to come to the hospital and have more aggressive treatment. If we can prevent that from happening, you know, then we'll save a lot of money for the healthcare system, but also a lot of time and energy for the patient.
With the help of this device, Pat's doctors were able to make a firm diagnosis and then implant a pacemaker, which saved his life.
I do walk slowly, but I don't have the shortness of breath. I can walk mile, half a mile, and I can do it. I have the confidence now. And that is, you know, that puts a smile on my face. I'm happy that I'm getting my life back again.
Holly Firfer, CNN, Cleveland.